Welcome. Thank you so much for being here. All right, so today is White Snake Spits Out Its Tongue. It's a variation of Chopping with Fists with a little bit of a different ending. White Snake Spits Out Its Tongue. This is one of my favorite movements. I really like this one. So I'll show you one time, and then we're gonna get into the details. We start and fan through the back, and we're gonna turn 180 degrees. We don't know what's coming from behind. So we're gonna turn and we're gonna press down and protect our head. We're gonna relax the right foot and make a fist. And instead of just chopping out towards the face, we're gonna flick with the fingers. And then if our opponent moves back, we're gonna use a palm strike. Right hand coming to the hip. Let me do it one more time so you can see from the other direction. Fan through the back. White snake spits out its tongue. We shift and we turn and we press down and protect the head. Then we're gonna circle in a little bit and make a fist and then step, chop and flick, palm strike into our bow stance. Ready? Let's start with footwork. We're in a bow stance with our left foot forward, torso's vertical. You're gonna start shifting your weight back. Keep your knees in line and turn on your left heel. Can you turn it 135 degrees so it's gonna go to this rear corner direction and your feet are kind of pigeon-toed? This rotation, where does it come from? It comes from your hip. So don't think about just turning your foot. See, can you rotate the leg, folding into the hips, rotate. Now, as you shift the weight to the left, relax on the ball of the right foot. So both feet are gonna face to this corner. Then we're gonna draw in and we're gonna step for our bow stance, but we're just gonna put some weight in first with our chop and flick. And then we're gonna move forward. Check, do you have two lines between your feet? So we still have that width of our stance, and then let's do it again. Left foot forward, torso's vertical, shift back, turn, use that hip rotation, knees stay in line with the feet. Then relax that right foot as you shift back. Pick up, step, and then move forward. Let's add in waist turning. A lot of our footwork also depends on the direction of our torso to help with the stability. We start, fan through the back, torso is vertical. As you start shifting back, you're gonna notice that you get that little bit of lean. Then we're gonna use waist turning, rotate on the left heel. Everything is going to the corner when we relax that right foot. Torso, both feet, legs, everything to the corner. Pick up, step, and we're gonna do a little chop. And then as we move forward, we're gonna turn from our waist, giving us a little bit more extension with that left arm. Ready to do the arms? Okay. From fan through the back. Something's coming from behind. You don't know what's coming. The first thing you do is you start shifting, and then as you turn, you're gonna kind of make a circle with the arms. So the left arm's gonna come up and the right one's gonna press down, okay? Turn directly towards your screens for a moment. We're gonna do this off angle so that you can see what's happening. So we have fan through the back. We're gonna go up and down together. What are we pressing down with? Center of the forearm. So we're connecting. We don't know what's coming from behind, and we're gonna connect with this part. We want to have our ski slope shape. So we have that gentle curve and we have that space between our torso and our arm. And the left arm is going to come overhead. This should feel similar to Fair Lady Work Shuttles with that warding off up. So final position, warding off up, right arm is pressing down, and you make sure that you have space between your body and that we're overhead. Second portion, we're going to make a fist, and as we make our fist, it's going to come in a little bit. So you're going to make a little turn and then use the elbow to rotate and chop out your face level. So we're using the back of the fist right here to chop, and we're using elbow rotation. But it's not just a chop this time. So at the last moment, you're going to flick out with the fingers. So we have that great line from the elbow through the fingertips. Okay, so from here, make your fist, chop, and flick. That's it. I want you to be aware of this left arm. This needs to come down to your shoulder. Okay, so as we're making our fist, it's going to come down. Why? We're gonna push for a palm strike. So the meaning behind this will help. Essentially, if we went for this movement and our opponent decided to move back, watch what happens. If I'm in line with the end of the door jamb, look how much more space you can get. Okay? So if you're going to attack someone and then they move back, you can just move forward in your stance to get that palm strike and more extension through your opponent. So we want to make sure that we're setting up for this. Our left arm is overhead and it's going to drop down, hand to the shoulder, armpit open, and then push straight out. That's it. It's very simple. The thing is, can you time it together? We're going to face this direction. We're not going to do all the waist turning, but I want you to get familiar and confident with the timing. So we have our left palm striking and our right hand by the temple for fan through the back. We're going to press down and we're going to protect our head. And this is the direction we'll be facing pretty much. We're going to make a fist. Then as you use your elbow to chop out, the left hand comes by your shoulder. And we're going to flick. One forward, one back. Final position, hand by the hip and palm strike. Let's do it with the footwork. We'll hit all of the checkpoints. Remember, we have checkpoints to check in on our alignment, but we want to make sure that we continue to flow throughout our practice. Fan through the back, vertical torso, palm strike, right hand by your temple, looking through your left palm. Start shifting your weight back, turn on your left heel as you cover your head and press down. This is number one. Two, relax your right foot and make a fist. Then three, we're gonna step out and then flick. As we touch and we root to the ground, we finish four with a palm strike. Let's do it again. Fan through the back. Vertical torso, palm pushing out, right hand by your temple. Shift back, press down, cover your head. Relax your right foot and make a fist. Chop, but then flick as you step and root. Palm strike as you move forward. Ready? Doing it again. Fan through the back. The best way to learn the movement is to do it again and again. Let's shift and then turn. Cover your head and press down with the right arm. Make a fist, relax the foot. Step, chop, flick, palm, strike, and release. The gaze always follows the action. So we're always following what's going on. The first piece of action is we're turning and we're pressing. So we're kind of seeing what's going on over here. Then we make our fist. Then we're checking out where that flick is happening. And then the strike. So we're always kind of looking towards this general direction. But what you'll notice is there's a difference from keeping your head stiff and staying directly this way versus looking more towards where the action is happening and where the action is happening. Do you see that little difference? So versus being straight and just staying straight the whole time, which I can kind of see what's going on, right? Peripheral vision versus being here and here. A little bit more intention, a little bit more clear knowing what's going on. Putting it all together, footwork, waist turning, arms, gaze, everything. Fan through the back. Shift, turn. Make a fist, relax the right foot. Draw in, chop, flick, and palm strike. Now, I know you're feeling good with that. Can we add on to it? Let's do it from that single whip position where we came from snake creeps down and go all the way through. Starting on the end of the room. Single whip. We came up from snake creeps down, so our hook hand is a little bit lower. We're gonna turn and open that left side, relax the hook. Shifting forward. Standing up. Golden rooster on one leg. Number two. Relax that left foot. Stand up. Pulse monkey. Three times. Number one. Pull and push. Go together. Use that elbow rotation. Step and strike. One more. And strike. Diagonal flying. Big circle with the arms. Step, turn, and open the arms. Raise hands and step forward. Stepping back, right hand higher than the left. Waist turning closes the arms. White crane down circle both arms. Left arm's gonna come on top. Close, step. Right arm passes on the outside to spread your wings. Brush knee. Two circles. Get that ski slope going and that right palm seated. Bring it to the shoulder so you can strike. Needle at sea bottom, reaching out, step closer in. Pull back, drop that right elbow, lift the left toes. Touch with the ball, and then hinge forward and sink down a little bit. Fan through the back. Left palm to right wrist, step wide enough, and then pull into that palm strike. Turn. Pressing down, cover your head. White snake spits out its tongue. Relax the foot, make a fist, chop, flick, and strike. We're getting closer and closer to the end of the form. All right. Thank you so much for being here. Always a pleasure having you. If you'd like to learn more about me and these healing practices, find me on Facebook and Instagram at Lady Tai Chi. Don't forget to visit my website, ladytaichi.com, and subscribe to the newsletter so you can be the first to know about all the exciting new things coming soon. Thanks so much for being here.